bless you. My name is Azola, and you are listening to Pastor Kwame.
Praise be to God. Amen. We are grateful to God for a new month. Amen. I want to give a shout out to my daughter for doing the intro for the month of September. Amen. One of the things I believe is that the goodness of God is not going to bring you this far and not take you to the end of the year. Amen. And so officially from me to you, I want to wish you a blessed and a favorable month of September. The number 9 is a birthing number. And so some things are going to be birthed in the spiritual realm. Some things are going to be birthed in your life. And I believe God and I declare that the birthing of joy, the birthing of peace of mind, the birthing of new ideas, the birthing of things that are to come will be something that will come into your life this season in the name of Jesus. Let's begin to honor God with me. Father, we thank you for what you are doing. We thank you for your favor. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your kindness. We thank you for giving us September in advance. We bless you. We worship you for that in Jesus' mighty name. You are good and your mercy endure forever. We stand declaring that something supernatural is about to take place in our lives. We stand declaring that anything that we couldn't do last month, to give us what it takes to do it in Jesus' name. I bless you, child of God. May this month smile on you. May this month be good unto you. May this month bring you prosperity. May this month bring you favor. May this month bring you joy. May this month bring you your husband. May this month bring you your child. May this month bring you smiles. May this month bring you divine orchestration of God's gift. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm excited. It's a new month. It's a month of September. Every darkness, every assignment of the enemy is abolished for you in the name of Jesus. Anything the devil wants to do, I take authority as a man of God and I declare null and void the assignment of the enemy for this month. For those of you in America, I want to take this time and wish you all you a happy holiday. Amen. And may God strengthen you. May God be good unto you. This month, it will be well with you. Hallelujah. I said this month, your health will be intact. This month, I pray that you will see the goodness of God. This month, I declare that there won't be any voice. Oh, God, help me. Let me speak to the storm that is coming to those in the coastal area of America. I declare in the name of Jesus that may God rescue his people. Amen. May God rescue every Christian in the coastal area. I put you under the canopy of God that this storm will not hurt you. I declared God's power over you in the name of Jesus. Be preserved in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. We thank God for your life. And those of you that are coming on Gifted platform, you are welcome to a place where we share the word of God. My favorite verse is that the flower fades, the leaf wither, but the word of God abides forever. Amen. Let me just zip it and start what God has given me for you on this day. I'm going back to my assignment today. I am reading from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 11 verse 6. 1 Samuel 11 verse 6. The Bible says now, then the Spirit of God came powerfully upon Saul and he became very angry. Very interesting scripture. And the Spirit of God came powerfully upon Saul and he became very angry. The Spirit of the Lord want me to speak this prophetic word over your life concerning the month of September. And for the month of September, God want me to tell you that there is going to be a divine shift of what we call a divine setup. There's going to be a divine shift, what we are going to call a divine setup. Hallelujah. God is going to do a setup. When it is a setup, it means that the order of activities and events has been set strategically for a final purpose. Hallelujah. God is going to position you in September. So you have to call your month of September my month of divine setup. Hallelujah. Let me exegete the text and give you a little background here. So this is right about the time that the first king of Israel, Saul, is being positioned. And as much as it was the choice of the people to request for a king, the Bible says that not every tribe was into it. People were were doubting whether Saul is really a person who can lead them. And so some of the people were speaking against the promotion. Some of the people were speaking against the fact that Saul is being anointed as a king. And it's always going to be like that. When you come into something, when you the first time you announce that you are going out, people will begin to say that, why are you going with this person? There's going to be a lot of people that will be happy for you, and there'll be a lot of people that are not happy for you. So at this particular point, Saul has been anointed as king, but the people, some of them were not feeling it. Some of them were speaking against him. So God had to do a divine setup. Oh, Father, I thank you for my enemies. I want you to say it by faith. You don't know what I'm saying, but just say, Father, I thank you for my enemies. So the first setup was that God had to cause an enemy of Israel to arise. So a king arose and decided to fight Israel. And when the king approached Israel, the people of the town the king approached, that the people said that, we are not ready and strong enough to fight you. So we are ready to be your slaves. Just name it and we will do it. And the Bible said, the king said to the people that, I want to take the eye of every one of you, so that it can be known that those without eyes are our slaves. And the Bible says, when this message got to Saul, the Spirit of God came powerfully upon him, and he became angry. And Bible says, when he became angry, he took an axe and sliced it into two and said that, anybody in the land of Israel and Judah who doesn't come to fight this battle, that's what I'm going to do to him. And the Bible says that fear came upon the people. And the Bible says that when fear came upon the people, they went and fought and won the battle. The Lord is telling me to tell you that this month of September, there's going to be a shift which is going to be called a setup, which is made by divine hand. And the strategy God is going to use, that God is going to set you up with the spirit that will cause you to do what you have to do. I love this verse because it is also, it has nothing to do with the battle. It has nothing to do with anything. The final verse said that, and the people who were not sure about Saul after this battle, they became sure, and they all came and said, now indeed you are our king. The Lord is about to do something for you this month, which is going to cause, you know, here's the thing. Sometimes the people you have called to serve, the people you are called to lead, the people you are called to minister to, the people you are called for your purpose to be advantage to them, they don't believe you. Don't take it personal. People just don't believe you because you say your name is ABC. God is going to set up some, oh God help me, God is going to set up something the month of September, and they will believe you after this month. I came to declare with my eyes open that after this month they will believe you. I said after this month they will take you serious. After this, oh God, after this month they will know you are the girl. After this month they will know you are the boy. After this month she will come, oh God help me. Most of the time that's what happens. The Bible says, now we know you are a true man of God. After this month they will say, now we know you are the girl. After this month the guy will tell you, now I know you are the wife. I said after this month the boss will say, now I know you are my employee of the month. May God shower his favor upon you. May God set you up to promote you this month. May God set you up to lift you up this month. I God help me. I didn't come to teach because it's the first of the month, and I stand as a prophet of God, and I declare that by the time this month is over, oh God help me, by the time this month is over, you are going to be positioned in a place where you will say, indeed God has made me glad. May Jehovah make you glad this month. May Jehovah favor you this month. Oh God, I declare over your belly that you are going to begin to flow with milk and honey. You're going to begin to flow with milk and honey. I declare over your belly that children are about to be born. I declare over your belly, increase is coming. I declare over your belly, increase is coming in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible said the Spirit of God came powerfully upon Saul, and he became angry. You know, when the Spirit come upon you, you're supposed to sing praise, not angry. But it's a setup. Everything that will happen this month, don't forget, say the man of God said it's a setup. It's a divine setup. Somebody will come and start something funny. Just remember, it's a setup. But the thing I came to do before I go is to declare the activation of that spirit that will come upon you. A spirit will come upon you this month. That spirit will cause you to finish what God has called you to receive. I push you, oh God, I feel it right now. I push you into the location of your destiny. I push you into the position of your destiny. I push you into the location that belongs to you. This month, I come against sickness that will come to kind of interfere with what God is doing. This month you will not get sick. Say amen. I said this month you will not get sick. Amen. This month it will be well with you. It is. Oh, I use my mouth to design your month. I use my lips to design your month. From my mouth to your heart, it shall be well with you. Believe it and you receive it. The Bible says, I'm a God that fulfilled the predictions of my servants. I don't care what the enemy says. This month it shall be well with you. This month you will do well. This month you will do well. Child of God, this month you do well, because a spirit from God will come upon you and a shift will take place. May God shift you into your right man. May God shift you into your right health. Some of you, your health has been a challenge for a while. May this month be a month where God will shift you. May you enjoy certain kind of privileges for the first time in this month. May you, oh God, help me. Anything that you are believing God for, may this month bring it closer to you. Anything that God has promised you, may it happen. Now, finally, whatever happens this month, I want you to know that it's a divine setup and God will work it. The whole verse I'm reading, it had nothing to do with Saul. It had nothing to do with the people they were fighting with. It had everything to do with those who were doubting that Saul is called by God. This man, those who are doubting your oil, a setup is about to be launched, says the Lord. That they will now believe in your business. They will believe in your ministry. They will believe in your gift. And they will believe in your calling. Father, we love you. Father, we honor you. And Father, we adore you. Whatever it is, your promises will speak. We stand, say, do your will in us. Perfect your purpose in us. Bring to pass what you have destined, and we will say of a truth, you are a good God. We honor you because you are faithful. In Jesus' name, amen.